Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, friends and colleagues, may I ask you to take your seats again. And while we are waiting for the scene to be arranged for our next agenda item, let me take this opportunity to welcome a few very special guests, personalities who have been instrumental in building the IPCC. We have just listened to speeches from Monsieur Charot and Mr. Steiner, the current executive heads of the IPCC parent organizations UNEP and WMO, but we have the pleasure of the company of further representatives of our parent organizations. Let me welcome Ms. Elizabeth Doudzwell, previous UNEP executive director. Liz has a very special relationship with the IPCC, and in fact, she was elected Working Group 3 co-chair for the second assessment period just a few weeks before she was appointed UNEP Executive Director. So welcome back to the IPCC, Liz Doudzwell. I'm also very pleased that Dr. Klaus Töpfer, who followed Ms. Doudzwell as UNEP Executive Director, is with us today. I remember Dr. Töpfer has put a lot of efforts into strengthening the IPCC and into actively promoting the dissemination of IPCC information. I really want to thank you very much for that, Dr. Töpfer. Dr. Mustafa Tolba, the UNEP Executive Director, who together with the WMO Secretary General has set up the IPCC 20 years ago, unfortunately cannot be with us today due to other commitments, but he sends his greetings and his best wishes. I also want to say a warm welcome for Professor Yan Hong, the Deputy Secretary General of WMO. The IPCC Secretariat falls within his responsibilities, and he has always been very attentive to IPCC needs. Thank you, Professor Yan Hong, for your patience and for your support. We also have with us today Mr. Michael Samit Kutayar. He was the first executive secretary of the UNFCCC, and he was instrumental in developing the good relationship between the UNFCCC as the political body and the IPCC as the scientific technical body. Let me also welcome my two predecessors, Mr. Sundara Raman, better known as Ram, and Mr. Jeff Love, the two previous secretaries of the IPCC. We also have with us current and previous members of the IPCC Bureau, in particular Dr. Robert Watson, previous IPCC chair, and co-chairs of the IPCC working groups. They will be introduced in a moment because they will be the main actors under the next agenda item. But I want to specially welcome the current and previous co-chairs of the Task Force on National Greenhouse Gas Inventories, Mrs. Thelma Krug, Mr. Takahira Ishii, and Mr. Pururahani Nyenzi. I will not ask them on stage because the topic they are dealing with does not lend itself very much to a panel discussion. Their program is just too technical, but it is very important and extremely demanding element of IPCC work. They have guided numerous methodology reports in the past years, and when you see the outcome of the volumes, you will agree it is really hard work. Ladies and gentlemen, colleagues, when we are celebrating 20 years of IPCC, we should not forget those colleagues and friends who are no longer with us. It was only end of last year that Professor Bert Bolin, the first chairman of the IPCC, passed away. We had hoped that he would be able to join us in Oslo and receive on behalf of the IPCC a Nobel Peace Prize, but unfortunately, he was already too weak. Professor Patrick Obasi, previous WMO Secretary General and one of the founding fathers of the IPCC, has also passed away. We also lost a number of bureau members, and I would like to mention their names. Mr. Abdullah Al Ghayn from Saudi Arabia, the first IPCC Vice Chair, Monsieur Jean Ripert from France, who chaired the Special Committee to Enhance Developing Country Participation, Mr. Mansour Seck from Senegal, Vice Chair of IPCC Working Group 1, Mr. Katsuo Seki from Japan, IPCC Vice Chair during the third assessment, Mr. Marufu Sinovera from Zimbabwe, Working Group Co-Chair during the second assessment, and finally, I want to mention Mr. Sam Tewungwa, the first Deputy Secretary of the IPCC. We had lead authors passing away, some very suddenly during the preparation of reports, and also delegates. Let us pay tribute to them and thank them for their contribution to our joint effort and success. But now, ladies and gentlemen, distinguished delegates, I have the pleasure to introduce to you Mr. Ralf Begleiter. He is Professor for Communication at the University of Delaware, and many of you will recognize him as former CNN World Affairs correspondent who will guide you through the next agenda item.